Hey everyone, Noodle here for a quick PSA. If you're having trouble with connecting your games to your Nova Lite, your PC, your dongle, or have some miscellaneous issues, here's some things you can try from the most basic to the slightly complicated. All the guides I followed can be found in the manual as well as customer support and the advice of people online. As always, closed captions and chapters are available if you're having trouble keeping up or if you want to skip to a different step. So the first thing we're going to try and do is reset the pairing for both of your controllers. With your controller turned on, hold down the home button and screenshot button for 3 seconds, and it should start blinking rapidly. When it starts blinking like this, it's now in pairing mode, so now all you have to do is to plug your dongle into your PC and press the button on top of it to put it back into pairing mode as well. Now all you have to do is wait for a few seconds for the dongle and controller to sync up, or you press a button on your controller and want it steady, that'll tell us that they're both paired. Sometimes when the dongle and controller are already paired, the light will still blink, so all you have to do is just press the button and they'll sync back up again. Next you can try is a forced reset. So flipping our controller around, there's a small hole here with the reset button. Just find something small like this needle and press the button that's inside for 5 seconds. According to the manual, this should fix unresponsive buttons and force your controller to turn off. Another thing we can do is reset the calibration on our controller. So what you're going to do here is to hold down these 3 buttons, the home button, the start button, and the select button, for 3 seconds until the light starts flashing white. Now you're going to press down the triggers 3 times and rotate the joysticks 3 times. To confirm your calibration, press the A button and the light should turn green again. Test your buttons to see if everything is back in working order. Last thing we can try is to update or roll back our controller. Now I'll start by saying that unless you really need to, do not update your controller. From what many people in my comments and online on forums have been saying, there have been some issues when they update their controller. There are reports of buttons that stop working or the controller itself that can stop functioning. In that case, you can try those previous steps that we just tried and that should help. For the Nova Lite, there's been reported issues with connectivity in Bluetooth and with the wireless dongle, as well as some latency issues. My controller came pre-installed with firmware version 5700 and I downgraded mine just recently and it worked just fine. If you want to continue though, proceed at your own risk and let's get into it. First, we need to download the GameSphere app on our phone. It's available on both Android and iOS for free. So I have an Android phone and to connect my controller to it, I need to hold the home button and A button down until the light flashes yellow. For iOS, you have to hold the home button and B button down until it flashes blue, and then for both devices, it should appear as a pairable Bluetooth device. Alternatively, you could use a cord to connect your controller to your phone and that should apparently work too. Hi, hello, Editor Noodle here. This screen is asking you to turn your GPS or location on so your controller can connect. Weird? Yes, I don't like it either. Anyway, back to the video. So, once we have paired our devices together, open the GameSphere app and tap on our controller. To our bottom left, you should see firmware upgrade. Now once you press that, a notice will pop up on how your controller might get disconnected from your phone if you continue upgrading. When you press continue upgrade, our controller will start flashing, but don't panic because it's supposed to do that. You'll know your controller is still connected when you wait for a few seconds, it'll start showing the battery and firmware version of your controller. If there was an error, your controller would have turned off and you need to reset the pairing on your controller to your phone. The most stable firmware version according to the internet is version 4200, and I recommend that everyone downgrades or upgrades their controller to this version because it's the least buggy at the cost of DualShock 4 support. A quick disclaimer though, if you want to upgrade to the latest version, which at the time of writing is 6900, you will need to update your wireless dongle as well, but we'll talk about that later. For now, if you're upgrading or downgrading, once you select your preferred version, just press the update button and wait for a few minutes. It'll prompt you to continue the update once more, and once it's done, it'll disconnect from your phone and you'll have to pair it again. For my model that I bought back in September 2024, as I mentioned, came with firmware version 5700. And while I can't check what firmware my dongle currently has, when I upgraded to version 6900, it connected just fine. So for the record, versions 4200, 5700, and 6900 work with whatever firmware is installed on here. If you want to use the latest version and your controller doesn't connect to the dongle anymore, you have to install the update for the dongle. I got the instructions and the update package from customer support. They took about an hour to message me back, but what they gave me is very simple to understand and do yourself. Once again, a bit of a disclaimer, it's in Chinese, but they did give English instructions on the document and the video that came with the package. Just follow what the person did in the video and everything should be fine. Is it shady? Yes. Is it your only choice if you want to use the latest version? Yes. I did try version 6900 for a few days and it worked out fine until I had to recalibrate my controllers and it was stuck on switch mode, so I reverted back to 4200. Anyway, that's all for this video. This is for all the people in my comments on my review for the Nova Lite. Sorry I didn't do my due diligence and properly research on the bugs and problems for this controller, and in the future I'll try to do better so I can come better prepared in helping everyone for troubleshooting tips. Gamesir, if you're watching and interested, please contact me if you want someone to do a video on how to update the wireless firmware. Anyway, thank you for reaching up to this point, and I'll see you in the next one.